In the previous video, we discussed how to use Git GUI with KiCad and also fulfilled client request by making various versions of the schematic within the same project. But most of the version control was happening within the local machine and by just one person, which is very unlikely in a large project. So in this video, we'll see how we can use Git Bash and GitHub for better workflow. Also, we'll see how to collaborate with various team members. By now, you should be familiar with how to use Git GUI and how to visualize commits. Because of its simplicity, it's highly preferable for beginners. But it's not quite an efficient way to use Git. So let's see how we can use Git in the command line instead of using the GUI version. First, let's start with creating a new KiCad project. Once it's created, open the project in the File Explorer. We can do this by right-clicking on the project icon and then clicking on Open Directory in File Explorer. In the previous videos, we used to include all the files that's within the project. Some of them are not necessary to be version controlled. For example, this cache file. To avoid these files and not include them in the version control, we can create a file called .gitignore and give a list of files and folders that needs to be avoided. We can do that by opening Git Bash and using this command. Once the file is created, open the file in a text editor and enter the list of files and folders that needs to be avoided during version control and then save the file. If you like to use the same list, I'll put a link in the description where you can download this. Since we have created the gitignore file, let's track this folder by using Git Bash. So open Git Bash and type this command. This command will initialize the entire folder and track all the changes. Also, it will create a hidden file called .git folder, which will have all the commits and the tracking details. Unlike Git GUI, in Git Bash, there is no visualizing the commit tree. So to see at what stage the files are in, use this command. This will show the current status of the repository. Here we can see there are few unstaged files that are highlighted in red. And also if you notice, it does not include any of the files or the folders that's within the .ignore file. Anyway, now to stage these files, we need to use the command git add and followed by the file name. Let's try the git status again. Here we can see we have successfully moved the .ignore file to the staged area. But adding files like this stage by stage can be tedious. In Git, we can also move all the files at once by using the same command, but now use the period symbol instead of the file name to add all the files to the staged area. And once all the files were moved to the staged area, we can see all the files are highlighted in green. Since all the files are staged, we can finally commit these files using the command git commit. And we can add a message by typing -m and in double quotes, type the message and then hit enter. And now when we try the git status again, we can see all the files are committed correctly and we have a clean working tree. So far, all the action that are performed is stored in our local machine, but working on a team with multiple talents would be a hassle if we have all the files only on our local machine. To solve this, we can either zip the entire folder and send it to the developers through Google Drive or Dropbox. But again, this would be a huge struggle tracking all the zip files and constantly uploading and downloading. This is where GitHub comes into play. GitHub can store this initialized folder as a repository and make the collaboration with other developers much easier. Here we can connect a remote repository with our local machine and Git will perform all the synchronization of files between the local machine and the remote automatically just with a few commands. First, we need to create an account in GitHub to create a remote repository. Once that's done, you can click on the plus icon and then click on new repository. And under the repository name, we can give our project name and fill in the description. Once that's done, just click on create repository. This will create an online repository. Now to bring your local repositories online, use these commands generated by GitHub. Now this will bring up a pop-up to log into GitHub. Now use the option sign in with browser and here click on Authorize Git Ecosystem and enter your password. And then click on Confirm. Once that's done, you can see our local files are successfully pushed to online repository. We can double check this by going to the GitHub platform. And here we have the repository that we created on the local machine. With this, we have successfully set up an online platform where we can collaborate with our team members. To better understand, let's try to use some real-time example. We'll add more characters to the scenario from the previous video. Apart from the PCB designer, let's include an electronics engineer for the documentation or coding and a mechanical engineer for external casing for the PCB. This team looks pretty solid. Feels like they can literally do anything. And by now, you should have an idea how we can initialize and add commits in Git Bash. Now let's see how we can create and check out various branches. But before that, let's create a circuit in KiCad. To keep things simple, I'll use the same circuit from the previous video. And then I'll just perform a commit. Now from the client, we know that we need two versions for this PCB. One is based on through-hole technology and the other one is based on surface mount technology. So in this case, I'll create two different branches where one branch is dedicated to the THT version of the PCB and the other branch is dedicated to the SMD version of the PCB. Use the command git branch followed by the name of the branch. In this case, I'll name this THT underscore version. And to see if the branch has been created, use the command git branch. And we have two different branches. One is a main branch and the other one is the THT branch. Now to check out to the THT version, use the command git checkout THT underscore version and then click on enter. And here we can see we are currently in the THT version branch. In this branch, we can assign all the through-hole components to these symbols. If you're not sure how to do that, click on the I card on the top right to learn how to assign a footprint in KiCad symbol editor. Once that's done, I'll perform a commit. Now similarly, I'll place the components on the PCB layout editor and route the components. And I'll commit whenever necessary. So I can go back in commit tree and check if something went wrong during the development. While I'm working on this PCB layout, the electronics engineer is free to use the main branch to submit their documentation files based on the circuit, since the circuit has been finalized by the client. So the THT development is done. Now I can push this version to the online repository by using this command. And when you go back to the GitHub, you'll have a compare and a pull request. Click on this. And then click on create pull request. Now when I go back to the repository's homepage, we can see here we have two different branches. One is the main branch and the other one is the THT version branch. Seems like the other developers have also included the documentation and the mechanical parts in the main branch. Now when I check the same in my local machine, there is no documentation nor the mechanical parts, because we haven't synced our local repository with the online repository, just like how we use push command to send the data from local repository to the online one. We can use the pull command to get the data from online repository to your local repository. Everything seems good. We have the local repository reflecting what's happening on the online repository. So let's follow the same process and create a SMD branch and complete the PCB. Now let's push the SMD branch to the online repository. So we'll use this command. Since the SMD version is finalized, let's merge the SMD files to the main branch. We can do that by using the command git checkout main. And here we can use the command git merge SMD version. Now we have merged the SMD branch to the main branch. So let's push this change to the online repository. To better visualize how the commits and the merging of branch works, we can either use git GUI or we can go to GitHub and click on insights. And under insights, click on network. Here we'll have a better visualization on when the branch is created and how the branch is merged. After merging the SMD branch to the main branch, I'll check again if the PCB layout is ready for manufacturing. Once everything seems good, we can just generate a Gerber file for the manufacturing process. It is sometimes okay to create Gerber file and commit it to the repository as usual. But again, tracking various Gerber files or zip files would be difficult with Git. So Git offers few other features that are used to maintain the build files and the finished project files. These are called tags and releases. To do that, go to GitHub and click on create a new release. And under this, click on choose a tag and I'll name this version 0.1.0 and then click on create new tag. If you are new to software development or to Git, this numbering system might be a little arbitrary at first, but I'm following the semantic versioning to name the tags. So if you like to do the same, I'll drop a link in the description which will explain about semantic versioning, or you can read more about this in the link provided by GitHub. Anyway, once the tag is created, I'll name this release and write a small description of what we did in this release. And under this, we have the option to attach the Gerber file. We can follow the same process to have a mechanical part as well. But to keep things simple for this video, I'll just stick with Gerber file. Once everything is set, just click on publish release. With this, we can track when the Gerber was released and at what version of the PCB development the Gerber was generated. This completes the video. We successfully connected GitHub with KiCad, along with various features provided by GitHub. But there are far more advanced topics like Git hooks, GitHub actions, issue trackers, and much more. But these topics will be for another series. In the next video, we'll see how we can analyze changes on the circuit on a graphical level using CadLab.io instead of just bare text that we used in Git. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and also share it with people who might be interested in this kind of content. And if you have any questions or doubt, please make sure to ask them at PCBcupid Q&A section. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.